Greetings, critical viewers, and welcome to The Wolf Among Us, Episode 3. Just came out today. Let's go.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie.
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane.
That piece of shit.
That motherfucking piece of shit.
Crane? Ugh, God, you think you'd know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know.
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
I just need to find Snow.
Why? What's going on?
Shit!
Crane's been... Oh, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine. Okay? Ah. It's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
No one cares about you, Beast.
Stalking Snow White. The room is covered in evidence.
I have to tell Snow what's going on right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
The Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When? Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby!
Man, a lot of stuff just happened.
Wait.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her. And you should tell her, but...
What are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
Got it. Something must be done, though. So we saw Crane destroy the mirror at the end of the last episode. I wonder what he's gonna do. What's his next move? Cause I'm not convinced that he's the bad guy, really. Like, I think he just has an obsession with Snow. I don't think that he's the killer. It doesn't make any sense. And of course, the killer's not gonna be revealed in episode 2. Come on. Some funeral, man. This is depressing.
You were part of a very special circle. People she trusted and cared for.
No?
I won't, offend you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will...
I'm not gonna interrupt.
Subside. I know as well as you that it will never subside. But I also know that the memory of Lily will sustain as well. And it will, in time, equal in strength to our mourning her loss.
Hmm.
And it is in that spirit that I'd like to talk about what you've all been so grateful to share with me.
I'll miss worrying about you. I'll miss our
how
fights.
How she could be stubborn and
you.
Patient.
Holly.
Rash and thoughtful.
Hmm.
How she carried a torch for the old ways, for tradition, for...
Now you will never die pageant. From indifference.
And most
lead
of all,
a tedious life.
It seems how...
Goodbye, sweetheart.
Lily loved...
Thanks for everything.
Dearly loved her friends
Vivian.
And family. She loved being
that's,
around
that's
them.
That's...
In good times
sweet.
And bad. I never met Lily, but from
you were
what
a big,
I've been told,
bright, shining star
I know in my
in
heart
shithole
that she
of
would have liked
town.
To be here tonight.
And I miss you already.
And now we'll have our...
Ren.
It's kind of an invasion of privacy to read these, but I'm an investigator. Fuck it. Okay. I'm done, I guess.
Bigby, is everything okay?
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
What did I do?
Look, Holly, I'm not here to start trouble.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here.
Wait, what?
After you lie? After you promise me?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it.
That's right.
I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
Whoa, what are you doing here? Oh, right.
Okay. I'm sorry, Holly. I didn't know he put her down the witching well.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help. And I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one isn't on him.
Like me, damn it.
Why are you here, anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I'm here to talk to Snow.
Oh, really?
Yes, Holly. This is serious.
Okay, look. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat far away from the ceremony, all right?
Look, all right.
Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea.
Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
Okay.
Holly, I didn't even want to crash this, okay? I had to, because of Snow. I'll be out of here soon.
See that you are.
All right.
Just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly. It's your turn to talk.
As much as I wish I could listen to this, I don't care. Let's leave. What? Grin? Alright, he didn't glare at me or anything. Whatever.
This better be wildly important. It's been hard enough making a connection with these people. When you pull this kind of stuff, it just resets the clock.
Crane murdered Lily.
What?
I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know.
God, this is really...
He's covered in blood.
This is a lot.
I know it was him.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't.
I know. It sucks.
I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it, to not picture him.
I thought you should be the first to know.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing?
Pretty damn sure,
because
yes.
Please, Bigby, don't confuse things. Deposing Crane would be the next step. And if we get this wrong, it would mean more than our jobs.
I'm not going to show her the photo.
We'd get kicked out of Fabletown for messing all of this up so badly.
Crane has been taking photos, Snow. Lots of photos.
Photos that show him...
He's been recording his visits with Lily.
God. Look, let's go back to the business office. I doubt Crane's there at this hour, but we need to talk. And this isn't the place.
I agree, but timing is everything.
Nurse? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
No, of course not.
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
Take your time.
No, I understand.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
This is important. Let her do this.
How'd it go? At the motel?
Well, I guess you didn't talk. Otherwise, you'd be over there, wouldn't you?
No.
I did. It helped a lot. Thanks.
I'm not gonna confide in you just yet, Narissa.
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Constable?
What?
Wait, easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do? That way, it's proper.
Now is really not the time for whatever you jerk-offs are planning to do.
Well, isn't that the thing of it? Plans. Except it isn't our plans you should be concerning yourself with. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
What?
Just
no deal!
Vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere. Just sit in your office and whistle to heaven for a few short days.
You're trying to pull this shit at a funeral? We can deal with this later.
No, not later. Later's too late. Right now. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone, and we leave you to yours? Brother, speak your mind. Fastly now. What's it gonna be?
I'm not gonna say shit.
Always wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose.
Yeah, now you guys are
a deal to work out with
in deep shit.
And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal?
He's getting mad.
Settle down now. Yeah, everyone just stay where you are. Nice and natural. Like we're just out having a spring picnic.
Stop this shit. Right now.
He hasn't exactly been a good sport about this. Not making our lives any easier.
Uh-oh.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
I didn't have any control over this!
Think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Yeah, listen to your lady, love.
Shit, okay.
Don't have to turn sloppy now.
Calm down, Holly.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead whore.
I'm gonna kill you!
Holly!
I got it, damn!
Give me a break! Fuck you! Fuck you in this shotgun! What?! What?! Wait, did I royally fuck that scene up? Or is this the only way it could have gone? Oh my god. That has to have been the only way it could have gone. I'm not convinced that I fucked that up by being difficult. I wasn't even that difficult. I did tell him, like, not here, not now. I can't do this now. Whatever. Tried to be the peacemaker. Didn't work out. So, what a way to kick off an episode, shit. And I think I say this every single time, but I really love this intro. Interesting, I wonder who their employer is. I also wonder why my voice cracked just then. That was kind of strange. Maybe it's the Crooked Man, according to the title.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder.
Oh, it was buckshot?
They'll eventually run their way out on their own, but until they do, you're going to be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy.
Damn, Bigby's ripped.
Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
How's everyone else? They all make it?
They're fine.
Oh, good.
I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived. So I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water.
Oh, God. I am so relieved that it's buckshot.
Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken. Your blood pressure's through the proverbial roof.
I'll try to.
All right, then. Very good.
All right. I'm being really cooperative.
I know. I'll have to call you back.
Is it Crane? Who are you working with?
I'm starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it, then. Miss White? Bigby?
Man, I'm always unlocking new Book of Fables entries.
So, to recap...
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
There's no other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this.
Seriously.
Don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it. But do you really think he killed those women?
I think
because
he killed Lily.
It's incomprehensible to me.
From what I saw at the Open Arms, everything points to Crane murdering Lily. What isn't adding up for me is Faith. Why would he kill her? It doesn't seem connected.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay?
Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure he was framed.
Just put myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did.
It did kind of go terribly.
I'm glad you were there.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake. Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you. But after tonight, it's on my mind.
What?
Why? What's on your mind?
It's just... when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe, in some tiny little bottled-up way, deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
Why even bring this up?
I guess it doesn't matter.
Guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror.
This is a weird conversation. Oh.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's not here.
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Buffkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything.
Oh.
He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror.
Well, but that's not
we
that
can
smart.
We solve this ourselves. I know
never
that
mind that. Come help me look.
Alright, time to do some digging. So, I'm pretty sure that Crane was framed. I mean, it's the only thing that really makes sense. Like, I know I've had Bigby say, like, oh, he murdered Lily and all that stuff, but I don't really think so. I think he was framed for the murder. I think he was just a creepy dude. I think he just has an obsession with snow. That's it.
Hi, Mr. Bigby. I can still help you catch Crane, you know.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. I saw him jump on the telephone before he left. He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is.
What?
His witch?
Yes, it sounded like the one he got his snow glamours from.
Hmm.
That's weird. See anything else?
You didn't see anything else, did you?
No, not especially.
What? Why was that pause for? Hmm.
Look, the whole mirror thing. It's not your fault, all right?
You mean it?
Yeah.
I like Buffkin. I'm not gonna interrogate him like that.
I'll just see if I can do anything about this.
You do that.
I like you, Buffkin. Please don't turn out to be evil. Nice. No. I'm gonna talk to you now. That was a strange conversation
says that he
she had earlier
calls
with him
before he left. Sounds like he's going to see a witch, or his witch, his glamour witch.
Wait, really? None of the 13th floor witches would allow that sort of thing. They must be somewhere in the city. It's something, at least.
Find anything?
No, but there's enough notes and stuff here to take all night. Maybe check that stuff there.
Oh, okay. I'll go check that stuff there. Here. Do it, Bigby. No. Go! Oh, it's on the other side. Let's open the drawer. Oh. Secret secrets. We'll read that one last. Ichabod Crane, are there any updates on the extra funding I requested? As I explained in my last letter, the conditions here could do with some improvement. I'm seeing some unrest from the residents, and I have to admit I can see why. The farm should not be a punishment. I'm sure you're busy, but I think this should be made a priority. Best, Wayland Smith. Huh. Interesting. What does that look for? Snow. I'm just reading his mail. I know it's a crime. Dear Mr. Ichabod Crane, I am writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning in our unit. It's burning up in the apartment, and Pinocchio says his skin is splintering. I don't know what that means, but I assume it's something gross, and I'd really like it if you'd fix the air like we asked you to 3 months ago. At the very least, provide us a fan in the meantime. Sincerely, Boy Blue. Bleh, bleh. Alright, Boy Blue, you've got some pretty insatiable demands there. Mr. Crane! You said you'd pay to have the plaster redone in my building after the last incident in 204. It's falling off the fucking walls! Please fix it! I can't rent out that room as it is, and I've already been waiting for days.
Not to mention you already promised me you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass on the front door. Well, guess what? It's worse now. Get your shit together. Mr. Toad.
Did Crane ever do any work?
Only when Cole was around.
Interesting.
What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
You still haven't told me what was in there. I want to know. I need to know.
A lot of blood and flowers.
I keep thinking back. I keep replaying moments in my head. Interactions with him when he'd catch me in the elevator or bump into me outside. There's only so much you can repress, you know?
You couldn't have known.
Snow, you couldn't have known.
No, I could have. Come on, let's keep looking.
Okay. Yes. This book, it's the key to progress.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
Good thing he did a shitty job of tearing it out.
It's a ring, at least.
Thank you, Bufkin.
Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fabletown. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Yeah, I only recently heard about this meeting. Why didn't you mention this before?
That's true.
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
Bluebeard, get the hell out of here. This is none of your business.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he spoiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
Yeah, because I don't like you.
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, please. Of course he is.
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Why do you even care about this?
Why? I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fabletown.
Yeah, you want a promotion.
Literally invested. Since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight I hear that Crane has been killing fables? And there's no system in place to catch him?
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing. You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office.
Holy
shit. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years now.
Unofficially?
Snow can handle it.
Officially.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
Fuck you, Bluebeard. Kind of annoys me that you're voiced by Dave
right,
Fennoy, but whatever.
Look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
2 a.m. Piece of cake.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And
probably.
Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
You want to get
it
the two Tweedles.
Doesn't matter what they know.
We get
After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
If Holly has Lily's things, That'd probably be the safer bet.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence. Before you had no interest, and now it's a crime scene.
Bluebeard, just stay out of it, all right? You'll just mess things up further.
They can't get any more messed up.
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
Are you going anywhere unsupervised?
I agree.
He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now.
So what do you...
Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
Oh, do I have to choose? Are you making me choose?
So Ooh. You leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy, and I don't need charity.
Oh, God. Which one? I kind of... Let me go to Crane's apartment.
Crane's place is right here. I should check that out.
I don't want Bluebeard going there.
And I'll go to those two imbeciles' office.
Crane's penthouse number is 1903. Let me know what you find. I hope you know what you're doing.
He can fuck with the Tweedles all they want. I don't care. They can both kill each other.